After trade d.eadline, Scott Brooks says Wizards are definitely looking to bring in a free agent. Now that the NBA trade deadline has passed, the Washington Wizards are prepared to make their big move. On Thursday, the Wizards traded second-year player Sheldon Mac and cash to the Atlanta Hawks for a protected 2019 second-round pick. The deal frees up salary as well as a second open roster spot, affording the Wizards a chance to pursue a free agent in the buyout market that follows the trade deadline. Although the team's front office did not find an attractive offer for a more significant trade, Wizards coach Scott Brooks said Washington will be active in potentially bringing in a new player. "We're definitely looking," Brooks said Thursday. "It does definitely give us some flexibility to add a player, or now we have the flexibility to add a couple players if we need. We all know this time of the year, players become available. Not only in the NBA but overseas." When asked which position the Wizards might look to add to their roster, Brooks did not want to reveal too much information. However, ahead of the Wizards' matchup against the conference-leading Boston Celtics, the sight of Washington's five-time All-Star point guard walking into the Capital One Arena on crutches offered the biggest clue. NBA trade deadline winners and losers: Lakers hit a home run, Celtics caught looking Wall will be out until at least mid-March as he recovers from left knee surgery. Though Washington won five of the last six games without Wall while relying on capable backups Thomas Satoransky and Tim Frazier, the team has targeted veteran point guards, according to several sources familiar with the Wizards' plans. "Don't really want to give our hand on what we really need," Brooks said, "but if it's going to make our team better and we have opportunities too, and we have some flexibility on our roster with this move to date to add another player or two." In the coming days and weeks, the buyout market will expand as veterans seeks to leave losing teams for a chance to join a playoff contender. NBA teams have until March 1st to sign a free agent so that the player will be eligible for the postseason. Although it's a long shot, the Wizards could also consider converting rookie Devin Robinson's two-way contract into a standard NBA contract. As a two-way player, Robinson, a 6'8" forward, has spent the majority of the year in the G League. However, if the team signs Robinson for the rest of the season on a rookie-scale salary, his two-way contract is voided. In 28 games in the G League, Robinson has averaged 13.4 points on 51% shooting, including 41% from the three-point arc. "We still are definitely developing him as a player. We like what he's done," Brooks said. "He's had some good moments this year and we brought him up. We still have that option. I like this potential. He's a long, athletic defender that can possibly be a pretty good three-point shooter in this league. A lot of teams, including ourselves, we like 3-and-D guys and he can be that type of player." Read more on the NBA: Cavaliers trade basically everyone, internet goes berserk. The Cavaliers won the trade deadline, and have emerged as a legit NBA Finals contender again. How NBA teams' reckless spending on 2016 free agents is crippling the market today. Chris Tapsport says his torn ACL is a cruel blow to a franchise that's all too used to them. The Wizards are winning without John Wall, but it's crazy to think they're better off.